He was such a good man. I couldn't have ever asked for a better father. He's such a good example and such a humble, godly person. And he taught me so much. He taught me to work hard. I am not entitled to anything. If I want something, I need to work and save for it. He taught me punctuality. It's not enough to be on time. You need to be early. That way, if there's any delays on the way, you still won't be late. He taught me not to quit. He used to always tell me, can't, never did anything. My mom and dad showed me what a great marriage looks like. They were best friends. And, you know, in all my life, I never, ever saw them fight. Not once, ever. And that's great for a marriage. It's not so great when you're a child and you ask one parent for something and you get the answer no, and you hope to get a different answer from the other parent, because it's not going to happen. Yeah, he taught me patience. He used to tell me I should pray for patience. He said, you should pray like this. Pray, Lord, give me patience, and give it to me right now. And that was another thing he taught me. He taught me to laugh and to see the funny side of things. My dad was so funny. And some of you, if you didn't know him very well, might have thought he was quiet and serious. But he was hilarious. He could be telling a story with a straight face, and everyone around him was rolling in laughter. He had a really dry sense of humor. One year at Christmas, we had a Christmas gathering, and he brought out a little dead tree. And it had no needles on it, but a single rifle cartridge hanging from it. And of course, everyone's wondering what this is and why it's out with all the rest of the decorations. And his response was, it's a cartridge in a bear tree. That is the original cartridge in the bear tree. In case some of you were wondering what that was, that he made, and it kind of became a Christmas tradition afterwards that we'd bring it out. He was hilarious. I thought that maybe when this day came that I would never be able to laugh again. I've always heard about the peace that passes understanding. And I believed it. I knew it was true, but it was sort of abstract. Now it's tangible. It's like almost like a physical presence in the room. And I grieve, but it's not without hope. I believe Jesus died and rose again, and so did my dad. So I know I'm going to see him again. And that gives me such a peace and a hope that I couldn't have expected to have. And it's not like a hope like, I hope I get what I want for Christmas. It's a hope that's sure. It's not a maybe. It's a done deal, like we've been learning on Wednesday nights at Bible study. And so that gives me a tremendous peace, even through the grief and even joy. I love my dad, and I'll miss him every day. And nothing will ever be the same. But I know that I'll see him again.